Está bien, perfecto. Entonces, primero, déjame decir que yo voy a hablar inglés. Por este tema, yo creo que es idioma muy adecuado. So, this is first time in 25 years I'm giving talk here in Instituto de Astronomía. I never actually been here. This is in spite of the fact that we are neighbors, maybe 300 meters away. I will talk about some absolutely remarkable new emerging science, which is called choreography, from physics perspective. I am physicist, I am not astronomer, I am not mathematician, therefore I view those things differently. So, title is Choreography in Newtonian and Non-Newtonian Gravity, a remarkable figure eight trajectory and all that. Remarkable, this word belongs to Montgomery, and my appreciation to him for this. First of all, let me start from Newton. That, as we all know, many years ago, Newton solved the problem of gravitational collapse in the case of two bodies. So we have two masses, those masses just attract to each other, and after some time they collide. This phenomenon is called collapse in physics. And of course the idea was just to avoid collapse and to have those masses just in existence. Newton's solution was very simple. We have to rotate those two masses and centrifugal force will equilibrate the force of Newton attraction and this system will exist. And of course this simple idea was immediately, almost immediately, in historical perspective, generalized by Euler and Lagrange, and they put n masses on a circle, rotating, and this was the way to avoid gravitational collapse. But in both cases, the Newton and the Euler-Lagrange system had non-zero angular momentum. But we know somehow by experience, at least in 20th century, that in many occasions which appear in physics, in nuclear physics, in atomic physics, etc., the lowest state is characterized zero angular momentum. So the question was how to solve the Newton problem of two attractive bodies for the situation when angular momentum equals to zero. Exactly for this reason, quantum mechanics was invented. Exactly to solve this problem of collapse, but of course gravitational interaction does not show up in small distances in micro world, but in macro world, situation's clear, this problem has no solution with zero angular momentum. But at small distances, where instead of Newton law, we should have Coulomb law, for example, this problem is solved, problem of collapse, just through quantum mechanical means. In 1995, Christopher Moore, that time, fresh PhD from Cornell. I'm sorry, I said 1993. Christopher Moore published article in the most important physics journal, which is called Physical Review Letters. Let me emphasize, not Nature, not Science, Physical Review Letters. And he discovered, playing with simply with computer, the following phenomena. he discovered that one can find a certain initial data for three equal masses. Initial data mean positions of the bodies and also initial velocities, that those three bodies will perform the motion which is presented here. So this will be figure eight trajectory, and each body follow to each other with a certain time delay. Seven years after, two pretty famous people, Alain Chansonnier, this is Paris, and this is astronomy or celestial mechanics, and Richard Montgomery, who that time was still topologist, independently, they solved the variational problem for the case of three-body Newton mechanics. They wrote action for this problem and discovered that in the space of loops, means closed trajectories, there is a solution with zero angular momentum, which correspond one self-intersection. This is this figure eight. They also proved, they discovered this pure mathematically without knowing results by Christopher Moore. They also proved that this curve, what appears here, is non-algebraic curve, it's transcendental curve. Transcendental curve means no theory. Lagrangian for this problem is presented here. This is kinetic energy. This is potential energy with sine minus. Furthermore, if you look carefully to this trajectory, to this remarkable motion, you will see that three tangent lines, they intersect in one point. And this point of intersection moves on some curves which look like as hyperbolas. Later on, together with Fujiwara, Montgomery showed that those curves where the intersection of three lines move, they are also transcendental. They are also non-algebraic. Now, this is introductory words. Let me now return and to the beginning and formulate the problem we are talking about. This is the title, What is Problem? After discovery made by Moore, Chansonnier, and Montgomery, the period of craziness appears since the people jumped to this field and started to look for such trajectories, for such closed curves, which can serve as trajectories for n-body problem. All this was made by manually. And the first person who made significant contribution to this field was Carles Simon from University of Barcelona in 2001. He discovered 700 trajectories of this type, 700 choreographies. Now the leadership belongs to a Chinese group. In Shanghai, they run one of the largest supercomputers in the world, exactly looking for such motions, such choreographies. So closed curve on which a certain number of bodies moves falling one to another. The question is that why actually people, computer science, really work looking on this. There is a problem which is not solved so far, how to choose initial data. How to choose initial conditions in three or n-body problem just to guarantee that the curve will be closed and appear choreography. Of course, this problem goes back to Poincaré, who was likely the first who formulated this problem. And of course, I could imagine that Poincaré had in mind our solar system, that we don't know what's special about initial conditions or even current conditions, positions and velocities of our solar system, which guarantee that we will have those, let me say, concentric ellipses, almost ellipses in the case of solar system. So the problem, this is a more or less clear problem in classical mechanics, and formulation of this problem is the following. So we have n-body problem in classical mechanics, for simplicity, with 2 degrees of freedom. So bodies move on a sum plane. Since this is many-body problem, the potential of interaction should be translation invariant. This, in particular, implies that the interaction depends on relative distances between bodies. No external fields. So the first question is, under what condition there exists closed periodic trajectory for each individual body on the plane? First question. Second question, under what conditions all individual trajectories are closed periodic and have the same form? Means that if we project those trajectories to the plane, they will project to the same curve. Hypothesis, what I'm going to talk today, is presented here. It's called maximal superintegrability. As we know that three-body problem in Newtonian mechanics, it's chaotic dynamics, realizes chaotic dynamics. This is theorem by Poincaré. From another side, Poincaré also showed that in three-body problem, in whatever position for arbitrary masses, there exist only 2 conserved quantities, 2 integrals of motion, angular momentum, total angular momentum, and energy. The hypothesis will be presented here. It claims that for a certain trajectories, there exist extra constants of motion, which are specific for this trajectory. For other trajectories, there are no such constants of motion. And for the case of n body on a plane, there must exist 4n minus 5 constants of motion. Out of those 4n minus 5 constants of motion, 2 known. This is global constants of motion, this is energy and angular momentum. This is idea. Now, let me just, as entertainment, show you a certain choreographies which people know. Four body. This is single curve, and we can count number of self-intersections, 4. And for 4 bodies, no collisions, and this type of motion exists eternally. Let me just pay your attention that in this point, there is no reflection. Of course, naively, one can see that this is reflection, but equations of motion don't support reflection in this case. But this means that if we will take microscope and look carefully to this point, it's not point of, it's very small loop. This is another three-body problem. Let me just remind that all those animations correspond to many-body systems in Coulomb gravity. So the potential of interaction between bodies is 1 over r. All this is play of initial data. Bodies. And let me again emphasize that in this moment, more or less, thanks to Chinese group in Shanghai, we know over 6,000 different choreographies. I cannot answer this question. For my knowledge, the maximal number of bodies, they have, this group has a web page where they regularly update this page and enter more and more choreographies. I never went beyond of 32 bodies. 32 bodies, partly due to Simo, and also there is a fellow from MIT who works in UC San Diego, Gregory, forgot his name. He actually collected a lot of information up to a certain moment, a lot of those choreographies demonstrated. But 32 bodies, it's enough just to enjoy. Let me emphasize, this is the single curve. But since I could imagine that there are a number of people who know astronomy, it should remind something. You know that recently extra satellites for Saturn were discovered, and now Saturn ring has more actually moons, more just these moons than Jupiter. Why not like this? But this is again, let me emphasize, this is plan, this is all those curves on the plane, those trajectories, planar trajectories. All those things occur so far for bodies of equal masses. Situation when masses are not equal are not resolved. It's much more complicated, and therefore, since this is computer science, what people do, that equal mass case much easier to treat, and correspondingly, all these equal masses, all those animations I showed correspond to zero total angular momentum. This, for us, it means that this curve, this picture, is not rotating. And no, this is extremely important. Velocities not equal. The velocities depend, velocity of each body depend on evolution. And here it's not really well seen, but we will talk about this. Velocities usually, since this is periodic motion, velocity usually change periodically. And the distance between neighboring bodies also change in evolution periodically. Yes, I answer it. Yeah. Okay. So in principle, I can continue. Let me just, since I'm not going to be extremely accurate, let me show you more animations for pleasure. In the end, I will explain why I just really prefer today to show more animations than usual when I give this talk. Four bodies. Uh, four bodies like this. This figure, this is a remarkable figure. It has name. It's called Super 8. Like this, five bodies. And again, no collisions, zero total angular momentum. Okay. And so I showed you animations, and what was very surprising to me when I discovered this animation, I felt incredible temptation immediately to run to the store and to buy a telescope, and just and to be amateur astronomer and to look to the sky. Up to my knowledge, I am not sure that astronomers really studied this carefully, existence of such trajectories, such choreographies. But nevertheless, all this is pleasure, fun, whatever, but all those things, unfortunately, obtained in computer science. It's solving of systems of coupled Newton equations. This is fine, and then you will get those curves, and then you will get those bodies on this curve, then you will get pleasure to see all these. But the question is that, what does it mean, all that? Why, in the problems which display chaotic behavior, exist a certain ordered motions? This is really the question. But we, as I mentioned before, all those curves, there is no mathematical proof, but no doubts, at least to me, that all those curves are non-algebraic curves, transcendental curves. Those curves occur as a result of solution of a system of coupled PDE, and that's it. So no description of corresponding curves. But in order to really approach to some description, we should really make a sort of analysis of all these, let's say, 6,000 choreographies, extracting is sort some systematic, some feature which we can try to investigate in whatever way, analytically, numerically, whatever. And the best curve to study turned to be the same figure eight. Okay, so this is from what I started. This is figure eight discovered by Montgomery, but this particular animation and the presentation due to Carlos Simon. Let's look at this and just scratch your head and say, listen, can we put more bodies on the same curve? Why not? One more body we cannot put. Reason clear, if we put four bodies on this curve, there will be definitely collisions, which we would like to avoid. Two more bodies we can add. So on the same figure eight curve, we can put five bodies, seven bodies. Let me emphasize, on the same figure eight. Once you see things like that, you maybe start to really believe to God, say that this is the same God-selected curve. Nine bodies. And eventually 19 bodies. And no collisions, energy conserved. What's absolutely clear here, once we saw this picture, this animation, that we deal with absolutely new physics phenomena. We have flux of bodies moving on a certain curve with self-interaction, with self-intersection, without collisions. Energy conserved. Yes, please. This is numeric analysis that you know. Therefore, I cannot answer exactly to your question, but looks like that the curve, at least extremely similar, and very close to each other. But we will come to this question. Of course, this is the first question to think that this is the same curve or not the same figure eight. But definitely we see phenomena, and this phenomena. Of course, it's clear that we can add more bodies. I simply did not search literature, did not search the archive provided this Chinese group, but I guess they should have many more bodies, odd number of bodies of this figure eight. I guess so, but I'm not sure. But 19 bodies on this curve, it's more than enough just to understand that we see physics phenomena. This is type of battery, storage for energy, energy conserved. And the current goes here and no collision in the point of intersection. Okay, so this can be shown. It's just, since we are poor people, we don't know how to deal with transcendental curves. Let's try to look for a curve, algebraic curve, which would have similar properties as figure eight. Also figure eight, but algebraic. Surprisingly, such curve is known. And in 1694, many centuries ago, Jacob Bernoulli discovered figure eight curve called Lemniscata, which is algebraic curve of degree four. And this is what I'm going to talk about. So we will take this Lemniscata. This is planar curve. This is the equation which describes this planar curve. And parameter C, really it's a so-called parameter of homotety. It measures the size of this curve. It's just large, small. In 2003, Fujiwara, with his co-authors, discovered that on this algebraic curve, one can put three bodies of equal masses. And also they discovered that this problem is potential. In fact, of course, this is always extremely difficult to read papers by Fujiwara, at least to me. But nevertheless, from this article, 2003, it was published in Journal of Physics A, you can see that, in fact, they, likely for the first time in classical mechanics, solve the inverse problem. You have trajectory, so means that you know evolution. You want to restore potential, if exist. So instead of taking potential and trying to find evolution, they solved inverse problem. And of course, when you solve inverse problem in this case, it's not guaranteed at all that solution exists, that the problem is potential, that there exists really potential motion. So the goal, this is what we are doing with Juan Carlos Lopez Vieira, is just to show that on the same curve, the same algebraic lemniscate, one can place arbitrary number, odd number of bodies of equal masses. And this problem is potential. So one can derive potential of interaction between those two bodies. So this is formal definition of choreography. So we have n identical bodies, means of equal masses, since this is gravity, in periodic motion on a closed orbit, chasing each other on this orbit with equal time spacing. This is what I already talked, but now just this is exactly the moment to return to the beginning and to say those remarkable animations, those remarkable choreographies I showed, those choreographies, just the consequence of Newton's law, that the two masses interact following the Newton law, or there exist other potentials of interaction, two body interactions, for which figure eight motion can occur. Not necessarily the same curve. And this study, at least again, the literature is very, I would say, spotty. It's very difficult really to have a vision of what's going on. But in 2016, it's not written here, Fukuda, one of the co-authors of Fujiwara, made a certain list of potentials for which figure eight occurs in the case of three bodies of equal masses. First of all, the potential when we have log R interaction between bodies. This is two-dimensional gravity. We know that the Newton potential 1 over R, it's in three-dimensional space. In two-dimensional space, this is log R. And he showed that for this log R potential, there exists also figure eight motion. And this motion, this figure eight, is very much different than the figure eight for the case of 1 over R potential. Also, it was studied this type of potential. This is, again, attraction at small distances. It's 1 over r in power alpha, where alpha runs, let me say, from minus 2 up to principal infinity. He showed, with co-authors, of course, that for the case of this potential, also there exists figure eight motion for three bodies. But this potential, let me mention that if this parameter alpha here, it's integer number, this is Newton interaction, but in the space of larger dimension than three. Also, it was very interesting observation about this potential. If parameter alpha here, degree, equals to minus two, which correspond to potential R squared, this is our celebrated harmonic oscillator potential, figure eight does not exist. So in the case of three body, this is a rigorous mathematical result. For the case of harmonic oscillator potential, this means that we have three bodies relating each other with springs, resortes, and there is no figure eight solution. Three body. But the most important thing what was discovered by Fukuda that for Lennard-Jones potential, which is the most important so far potential in molecular physics, it's presented here, also there exists figure eight motion for three body, and this trajectory, this curve, there are many different curves corresponding to this figure eight. With some bendings, with some really sharp changes, very, very strange. They found many three-body solutions on figure eight in the case of Lennard-Jones potential. But Lennard-Jones potential, this is the potential which was invented in order to describe molecular physics. This is the potential of interaction in the case of diatomic molecules in Born-Oppenheimer approximation. So this is just the interaction of two bodies. Everything is in the plane. I'm not familiar with a single result beyond of the plane. Of course, special curves should exist. I'm sorry?
In three dimensions, there is nothing.
No, nothing. I'm not familiar. No, this is, it doesn't mean nothing. That it's again, this is computer science, so computer physics, and therefore people work to work on the plane, it's easier, less degrees of freedom. Okay. Now, just Lemniscate. This is this equation for Lemniscate. This is this beautiful pattern of the Lemniscate for the case of C equals to 1. This is just usually standard consideration. We fix C equals to 1 here. When Bernoulli discovered this Lemniscate, he wrote trigonometric parameterization of this curve. Of course, we know that if curve is closed, we can introduce parametric, a certain periodic parameterization. But then Fujiwara, with co-authors, wrote such a parameterization of this Lemniscate using Jacobi elliptic functions. Fujiwara didn't give reference. I don't know, maybe Jacobi found this parameterization, but at least I don't know literature at all where such a parameterization will occur. This is SNSNM, this is Jacobi elliptic functions. Argument is t, it's not time, it's t, it's some parameter t. K, which appears here, this is so-called elliptic modulus. And this elliptic modulus, this is some extra parameter for which characterize the fundamental domain for elliptic function. Again, it's not important. What's important that this parameter k runs in the interval from 0 up to 1. And if k equals to 0, we return to trigonometric parameterization found by Bernoulli. We can pure formally calculate period on this curve. We can put point here. This is not dynamics at all. I put point here and ask how much, what would be the change of parameter t, which appears here, for point to return to the same point from what I start. If it would be physics, I would say call it period, but this is not physics, it's parameterization. So this parameter t, denoted here t capital, is written here, and we can see that this t capital needed to return to the point, to initial point, depends on this parameter k. Depends on parameter k. Okay, good. Now let's just make evolution. Evolution is very standard. We put one body in one point of this curve, another body in another point, third body in the third point of the curve, and those points on the curve are chosen in such a way that this parameter t, parameter of parameterization, is here for first body, it's just t itself. For second body, it's shifted to the, let me call it period over 3, and here also shifted period over 3 with opposite sign. So this is just definition of evolution of three bodies on this curve. And x1 and x2 is just what's presented. What was presented in the previous slide. The first problem to solve is just to fix center of mass. Since, of course, this is three-body problem, the center of mass cannot be fixed. Or move with constant velocity, whatever. But for simplicity, we can simply fix it and put the center of mass coordinate equals to zero, what's presented here. And let's take, of course, center of mass coordinate is vectorial coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate. Let me show what's happened for the case of x coordinate of center of mass. As a function of this k, elliptic modulus k. And you can see that with evolution, in principle, center of mass moves, and moves periodically. We can see if k is fixed. But there is a very special point. K, which appears here, correspond to the situation when the center of mass fixed. This was found by Fujiwara. But what was interesting, if you make the same plot for y coordinates, it also, you will see certain evolution for arbitrary k. But again, for the same k which appears here, center of mass in y direction also fixed. This is miracle. It's, believe me, this is absolute miracle. What is this value of k? And Fujiwara found that this value of k is given by this number, this transcendental number, irrational number. Furthermore, he showed that this number k, which appears here, is solution of highly non-trivial, highly non-linear elliptic equation. So this is Sine, Jacobi elliptic, elliptic sinus. This formula, which is very important, nobody, let me just assure you that nobody ever saw equations like this with a solution like that. This is really one of the today's searches, what in particular I do myself, that it's just to find the place in fundamental physics where the equation like this can occur. Since Fujiwara derived equation, similar equation for the case of five bodies. I will show this. But what was extremely important to mention that so far, for three-body case, all results can be obtained using the means of complex analysis. And this is actually what Fujiwara did. He used standard knowledge of complex analysis and solve this problem. For five-body, it does not work. For three-body, it works, and maybe I will take a chance to mention why it works. So this is just, if we take this value of k0 of elliptic modulus for which center of mass fixed, we immediately arrive to two remarkable unknown transcendental identities. Identities for elliptic functions. Now, initial condition. As I mentioned, that the problem can be reduced to how to choose initial condition. First of all, it can be seen visually that there exists a line, there is a moment in evolution where all three bodies, like in the solar system, are on the same line. Of course, this type of property was absent in earlier Lagrange solution. This is just really consequence of this figure eight solution. So there exists a certain moment in evolution, some time t, when all three bodies are on the line, and you can see that distances between bodies the same, should be the same. Velocity of the center of the central body. This line occurs in the moment when one body cross the point of intersection of this figure. So in this case, this velocity is double comparing to velocities which are for the endpoint bodies. And of course, you can immediately see that the sum of velocities equals to zero, as it must be, since all this picture is not moving. And then we have to choose very specific values of this distance a and this velocity v. It's presented here. If a squared equals to this parameter c, you remember this parameter what appeared in definition of figure 8, and velocity is also written in terms of c, in this case, it can be explicitly demonstrated the evolution will follow figure 8. If you break this condition, no figure eight at all, and since this is again, this is also a chaotic system, and instead of this, you will get complete mass. No order, Okay. Now, once we are lucky and we found this Euler line and we found this condition for figure eight on algebraic Lemniscate, let's come back to three-body Newtonian problem, where this is just three-body curve which correspond to Newtonian figure eight. It's clear the differences. Previous one was figure eight corresponding to Lemniscate. This one is figure eight, which was found by Moore, Chansonnier, Montgomery, Simon. And you will see, first of all, there exists in this evolution also moment in evolution where all three bodies are staying on the same straight line, just here. And then also velocities, this central velocity, it's twice more than this end side velocities, etc. And then we can see, and also the angle between velocity, this central velocity and horizontal line, it's just 56.9 degrees. This is Simon. But then we can just say, maybe we can somehow compare those two figure eights. And this is comparison, which made really people who know all this absolutely crazy. You can see that those two curves almost coincide. If you calculate deviation of one curve from another, this chi-squared, the chi-squared, it's not written here. It's of order 10 to minus 7. So those curves are extremely close to each other. You may ask, what is this that from one side, we have figure eight by Moore, which is transcendental curve. But from another side, we have algebraic Lemniscate, which is algebraic curve of just order four. How possible that they coincide with such accuracy? This is one of the mysteries. So there are many mysteries in this field, and this is one of them. Now, the question what I was asked about the evolution, about how velocity changes. First of all, how direction of velocity change with evolution, direction. In the initial moment, when the body is staying in the point of intersection of figure eight, you have maximal possible velocities, and then velocity, of course, body starts to move and velocities start to rotate. And so it rotates and simultaneously the modulo of velocity decrease. And in this moment, this is one quarter of period, velocity takes minimal value. And then it starts to continue to rotate here. And this is just the moment of half period. Velocity takes a certain value, but not maximal at all. If you will continue evolution, the direction of velocity starts to go backward. This means that velocity never ever in this evolution appears in this sector. Why it's like this? It's again, this is just, all this is, you calculate and you see. At least you should start feeling that how non-trivial dynamics in the case of three-body Newton problem is, if for the case of algebraic Lemniscate we see such non-trivial things. And the modulo of velocity changes periodically from maximum in the point when body is in the section, then it reduces, then increases, etc. So it goes periodically. Furthermore, the distance between nearest neighbors also change periodically. You can see this as changes periodically. This is very, let me say, unusual dynamics from our perspective, that in dynamics, we have changes of velocities of components and also changes of the distance between neighbors in the dynamics. This is very unusual. Okay. Now, how to find potential? We will not follow the ideas of Fujiwara. We will have our authentic way to do it. First of all, it can be shown, since we know evolution, that such a product of relative distances between bodies is constant of motion. You can, since we know the evolution, we can substitute here, see that this is exactly constant of motion. This is one of the constants of motion which occur in the situation when Poincaré theorem does not work. This is extra constant of motion. Also, the squared, sum of the squares of relative distances, this is nothing but the squared of hyperradius. It's also constant of motion. This is the definition. Kinetic energy is constant of motion. Surprising, not terribly surprising. Since we know once we have a body on a rope, we just do, of course, the centrifugal force just change only the direction of velocity, but not the modulus. So kinetic energy for body on a rope also conserved. But here. This I don't know. And furthermore, now let's make a wild guess. Those two constants of motion, they don't depend on velocities. And correspondingly, we can say that potential, which is also conserved, if kinetic energy conserved, potential is constant of motion, it's clear. So let's look for potential as a function of those two velocity independent constants of motion. This is first guess. The second guess, for reasons which we don't understand, nature loves very much pairwise interaction. And the three body, four body, more body interactions are rare. They exist, but usually small. But two pairwise, two body interactions, typical. And of course, all this gravity, this is really two body interaction. Correspondingly, we can pay attention that if potential is taken in such a form, log the first expression, minus or plus log plus the second expression, we will have potential in the form of sum of three pairwise potentials. Let's make such a guess. This is another guess. And in this case, if we are lucky, we have to find those parameters alpha and beta. The miracle is that this is the case. And let me, just before moving ahead, show you the list of constants of motion beyond of Poincaré theory, beyond of the global constants of motion. Angular momentum and energy, this is constants of motion. This is Poincaré. This is, I just showed you, this is two extra constants of motion. For other motions, for other evolution, those things are not conserved. They are not constant. Product of velocities, amazingly, also constant of motion. Again, you don't trust me, take evolution, substitute, and see that this is constant. Kinetic energy also constant of motion. And there are three more very strange constants of motion which are presented here. Only two of them are independent, since some of them can be written in terms of the kinetic energy and this squared of hyperradius. Okay, now, what we can say, since we made analysis of those constants of motion, and we found that we have seven independent constants of motion. What does it mean that? It means that if we calculate Poisson bracket between Hamiltonian and one of such constants of motion, this is not zero, but on trajectory, on Leibniz gate, it's zero. This is new type of integrability. This integrability called particular Liouville integrability. Integrability which exists only on trajectories, not globally. For standard integrability, Liouville integrability, Poisson bracket equals to zero. But here, no. But in total, we have 7 constants of motion after removing center of mass, 2 global, this is energy and angular momentum, and 5 particular, for which exactly this condition fulfilled. Therefore, and all those constants of motion, surprisingly, polynomials in coordinate and momentum. This means very simple. Therefore, this particular trajectory, algebraic Lemnitz scale, it's closed periodic trajectory, which is particularly maximally superintegrable. This means that the number of constants of motion, in a certain sense, it's maximal possible. We cannot add more constants of motion. If we have one more constant of motion, no dynamics. Point in phase space will be fixed. Okay, now potential. So in order to find potential, as I said, this is inverse problem. We have evolution, this is Newton equation. We have evolution, and we want to calculate potential, if exists. So we have to solve consistently for Newton equations of motion in order to find potential, not evolution. Evolution is given. It's very easy to see once you just make all right substitutions that the potential is really this sum of those two terms, as was guessed before. And coefficients are very simple. It's 1/4, and this is another coefficient. Fujiwara, with co-authors, using the, as I said, means of complex analysis, found the potential explicitly. But this is simply another way to find potential. This is the way, this is the potential. Now look to this potential. And of course, Fujiwara in his paper writes, very strange potential. And I fully agree, this potential, this is log potential, log term, so it's just attraction at small distances. But at large distances, it's repulsion. Potential goes to minus infinity, so this is anti-harmonic oscillator. And if you look to some serious books on mathematical physics, on spectral theory, you will find that the worst potential which exists in life, in mathematics life, is the potential minus x squared. Harmonic oscillator potential, but facing down. But let's not be scared. And let's ask the question, where the trajectory is in configuration space. This is the potential, pairwise potential. But trajectory, what we study, appears in this domain, exactly in this domain. It never goes beyond of the tip of the maximum of potential. Nothing wrong with this. This plot reflects the very simple statement that if you have trajectory and want to restore potential, you can restore potential unambiguously only in domain where of configuration space, where trajectory is, not beyond. Beyond is just continuation, analytic, non-analytic, whatever type of continuation. And therefore, this formula is just nothing but analytic continuation of the potential which appears in this domain from here up to here. And this leads, this continuation leads to this artifact of this sine minus r squared. This actually means that we can put here to the tip of the potential infinite wall, nothing will change. This is clear. Okay. One word about trajectory. Why Fujiwara with co-authors managed using means of complex analysis to make all this analysis and to find potential? The reason is that the trajectory intrinsically, it's elliptic curve. And we can see it here. If we will construct the trajectory in the 3-dimensional space of relative distances, this trajectory, it's again planar curve. This is completely different curve. This is not figure eight at all. This is space of relative distances. But this curve appears as intersection of plane. Rho is just relative distance squared of plane with a certain type of hyperbola. But this curve, following the classification, this is nothing but elliptic curve. And correspondingly, those constants which appear here, which is constants of motion, have a meaning of so-called elliptic invariance for elliptic curves. Now, in order to finish, let me very briefly to say what's going on in five-body case. In five-body case, the same procedure, we put evolution of five-body evolution of the same figure eight, the same figure eight, and exist two different values of parameter k, which is elliptic modulus, for which center of mass can be stabilized, can be fixed. Those numbers presented here. Correspondingly, evolution appears here, and you can see how five-body moves here, very much similar to five-body motion on the stand in five-body Newtonian gravity. How to find those non-trivial values of k? This is again Fujiwara, but no idea how to derive those things. There are two equations which should be satisfied by the values of elliptic modulus. Following what grounds Fujiwara wrote those equations, this is completely unclear to me. And this would be really very nice to understand, and I really call mathematicians to try to explain how to derive this. Okay, this is, let me skip it, just Fujiwara writing this, this is article of 2004 about five-body evolution. He said that very likely this evolution is not potential. This means that there exists no potential. Juan Carlos found this potential. Let me show this potential explicitly. This potential was found. Yes, okay, I just really near the end. And this is just really a potential, how it looks like. And those parameters in front of log term, the same alphas and betas are just much smaller than for three-body case. But what's very, this is again, this is the potential, this is a consistent solution of eight Newton equations of motion, but in inverse problem, looking for potential instead of evolution. So potential exists. And let me just really proceed to the end, to the seven-body case, and really finish this. For seven-body case on Lemnis gate, again, there exist three different values of k. They are presented here, three different evolutions. They are not the same, yes, not the same. They don't have it, but the constants of motion are very different. Different, this again, I have no time to talk about this, but this is just all this regulated by constants of motion. But what's important, that in this configuration number three, when K3 is almost one, bodies almost stop here. In the horizontal line. It reflects some absolutely non-trivial phenomena. Velocities cannot be zero. If velocity is zero in any moment, this immediately leads to collapse. Velocities, so this means that we are living in motion. And in order to finish all this, let me make the final word. My final word. As you know, 2 days ago, As you know, 2 days ago, the Nobel Prize winners were announced. And out of those 3 Nobel Prize winners, 2 got the Nobel Prize jointly, the Meyer and Kellogg, for discovery of exoplanets and investigation of exoplanets. Recently, Meyer gave an interview, and he was asked about the history. And he said something, he said the following. Up to more or less 1940, nobody in astronomy community believed in the existence of exoplanets. There were really very few strange people who said that exoplanets can exist. But in 1940, something changed. And all this astronomy community changed and said, there must exist billions of exoplanets. This is 1940. But then in 1995, they discovered the first exoplanet. How many exoplanets know now? Over 4,000. Exactly, over 4,000. I call simply people who are close to astronomy to just look for such choreographies. Why not such type of constructions in this? Of course, this is one of the arguments. Of course, they don't have the same mass. But we have in this galaxy 10 in power 11 stars. How many out of these 10 in power 11 stars have equal mass? The same question. What's probability that for the case of a solar system to encounter initial condition which leads to evolution what we have? What's probability to encounter out of these 10 in power 11 stars? Zero. But nevertheless, it exists, and there exist also over 4,000 exoplanets. And for each exoplanet, you can ask the same question. What's probability to encounter initial conditions which will lead to existence of solar system? And again, believe me, it's zero. Well, one can calculate this a little bit more accurate, but it will be definitely beyond of all possible accuracies we can imagine in our life. This is only what I want to say. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you to Professor Alexander. Question?
I must say, your presentation is beautiful. All these figures are really a pleasure to see. And we could see all the girls dancing and the...
This is fantastic. Let me give you a small remark to what you said.
Let me get to the point. What I'm trying to say is that you mentioned that there might be some cases in astronomy. There might be in nature, yes. The trouble is that we cannot find them because we are unable to follow the motion with such care, and time is... It's very delayed, and we cannot do that. So we are not able to look at that. If it's present, we will never find it. That's my point.
No. I believe me. There are many more objections and doubts, etc. And of course, this is absolutely clear. And the universe is very dilute, and etc. There are many arguments, but nevertheless, solar system exists. We have no doubts in this. With probability to find solar system zero. But let me answer the first part of the question. This is the history of this choreography. In 19th century, famous French choreographer Marius Ptipa left France for Russia, and he lived and worked in St. Petersburg. And he staged many ballets, In particular, he staged ballet called La Belvedere, La Bayadere. And in this ballet, in the second action, there is absolutely non-trivial motion of ballet dancers, of ballerinas. 32 ballerinas follow figure eight, follow figure eight, and then, I have an image, I can show you how it is, but what's visible, how difficult for ballerinas to follow, since the velocity should be changed, and also distance to the partner here also should be. Therefore, they are only able to do at most two periods, and that's it. And that after that, all this just really blows up. There is a problem how they can stop this motion. It's just it, you start it, and then how to stop it. And the only way, in fact, to stop it is just really each ballet dancer takes transverse velocity out of this figure eight curve. And this is how they stop this, since the curve is very unique, sufficiently. And then the natural question comes, if such things exist in ballet, this was my motivation, if it exists in ballet, maybe, which is human being, this is just biological nature, but maybe it exists also in situations where the motion is governed by physics law. Not by brains of brilliant choreographer. No, this is the goal of my talk was exactly this. Just what can be the way to detect such motions? This is my message.
Well, it was quite interesting, and I have several questions. Well, and a comment. The comment is that perhaps we can detect something like that because it is stable to a certain point. Not to measure. I am not sure to measure the velocities and so on. But perhaps something stable of this kind is possible to detect. So I think it's
stability.
An open question to try to find something there.
Let me just answer this question. Stability of three body on Newtonian gravity was investigated. There is rigorous mathematics proof by again Montgomery with some other co-authors that this motion, this figure eight, is stable with respect to small deviation of initial data, but not all. So this is, let me say, almost stable.
Yeah.
Like in our solar system, it's also almost stable for the last 4.5 billion years. it's enough.
I have some other questions, and not regarding to astronomy, I think that for simplicity, you assume similar masses.
But no, the same. Not me. It's just other people.
Yeah, but what happens if you put some double mass or something or anything like that?
Nobody knows. Answer
it's
is
another
nobody
question.
Knows. And nobody investigated.
And the other, you mentioned the choreography of the ballet, but perhaps it's a way also to design some traffic routes or paths or something. It's interesting to
You're absolutely right. This is the immediate idea. Of course, astronomy, beautiful science, mm-hmm. everything is complicated since you should look at the sky and you cannot make experiments, etc. But there is a science which is accessible. It's molecular physics. Mm-hmm. It's absolutely clear that in molecular physics, thanks to this indication due to Landers-Jones potential should exist moving polymers. Yeah. Moving polymers, polymers which you cannot stop. And this polymer can contain, I don't know, three atoms, four atoms, not two. And that's it. This can be really, and it would be, and the experiments in molecular physics from this perspective, much easier than in astronomy. You cannot make experiments since only he can make, or she make experiments.
Okay, so we want to say again thanks to the expositors. So that's all. Thank you very much.